I will talk to you a bit today about Ampere. Ampere is a joint program from ERA, so the European Energy Research Alliance. So Ampere is a joint program on advanced material and processes for energy application. We mostly address basic science in the field of material and processes related to energy. So we try to promote and to develop science into the field of future emerging technology in the field of material and toward energy application. So at the beginning of my talk, I will try to show you how works Ampere and what we do within Ampere. And after that, I will show you some example of potential interaction that could be possible between Ampere and EQUE. So Ampere is organized as follows. This is a kind of matricial structure with pillars and application sub-programs. So there is six sub-programs. Three of them are what we call tool sub-programs. One is on new materials. One is on physical modeling. This is multi-scale modeling, in fact. And one is on advanced characterization. So SP1 and SP3 are the biggest one within the project. Modeling is, I would say, the smallest part of the tool sub-programs. And there is application transversal sub-program which are related to these tools. So actually there is three sub-programs which are clearly identified. One on artificial photosynthesis, which is the most mature, I would say. One on material operating under extreme condition. And one on low temperature heat recovery, which was also an important application in energy application. And there is other imaging field, and one of these field is membranes. There is a lot of topics that are no running on membranes, and I will show you later in the field of application. So Ampere is a joint program. ERA gather many joint programs, and this is all the sub-programs, the joint program of the ERA. So some of them are dedicated, a lot of them are dedicated on a specific application for energy. Ampere can address and make exchange with different joint programs from the ERA. This is the case, for instance, between fuel cells and hydrogen. We have a lot of exchange between Ampere and nuclear materials, where there is also a lot of issues that are interesting for both communities. So we interact and we try to make a joint session to promote some topic and to see what can be done. Actually, we are 14 countries within Ampere, 32 organizations. It's increasing. Well, there was a bit more at the beginning, but the ERA has changed its status 2 years ago, and after that, there is fee to pay, and only interested partners are remaining within Ampere. But the ones who are there are very active, and most of the big, I would say, the big academic leaders within Europe on the field of materials are present within Ampere. So how it works? We have these six sub-programs, tools and application. For each sub-programs, we have two coordinators to promote the action within sub-programs. One main coordinator and one deputy. We have a management board that gather all the coordinator of the sub-programs. And we have a steering committee where everyone within Ampere and around Ampere is invited to discuss, and we meet at least two times a year to have a management board and to also have workshops on dedicated topics on research for materials. So I will show you that this works, and this works with pretty no money because Ampere is not funded, or at least very there is a small amount of funds, but we still manage to work together and to meet at different places. We are coordinating action also with Emery. Emery is an initiative from industrial partners that are also interested in research for material and new materials for energy application. So they are most involved in ITRL level. So we are quite complementary, and we try to push together with Emery and Ampea some action toward the Commission to push some topics for the next call. So we start in 2012 in Paris, and since that we have met, as you can see, every year, almost two times a year. At the beginning, this was mostly on management of the joint program that was necessary to start. But after that, since it works, we have tried to join to this management meeting some workshop, and we have a workshop which was quite broad at the beginning, but now which are more focused on application. And we have, for instance, workshops on modeling in London in June 2015. We have a workshop on membrane, which was the last time at SINTEF in Oslo. And we will have, for instance, a workshop in November in Prague on catalyst material. So this is for action within Ampea. But we have also action with the other joint program. We have organized in Brussels 2 years ago a meeting with other joint programs coordinator. There were 11 among all the joint programs of Europe, all interested in materials, and we try to during this workshop to identify some hot topics, some that can be interesting for many of us. And within these topics, some of them are clearly related to computation. The first one, which is on hygiene and degradation of materials, this is closely related to, I will say, material operating under extreme condition. And in that case, there is a need for characterization, but there is also a need for modeling how material can are going to degrade and to be subject to failure. And the last topic also is one of the thing which is emerging quite strongly. This is the design of new materials supported by modeling. So in silico modeling of new materials is something that is rising within Ampea with a lot of projects that involve this part of research. So Ampea have also the ability to label some projects, and people who apply to call and answer to proposal are labeled by Ampea since 2-3 years, you know. And there was a certain amount of projects that have been proposed in case of FET, in case of NMBP. In the case of Marie Curie action also, I will show you some example after. Just before talking about application related to high performance computing, we said that Ampera is mostly composed by people who are doing elaboration and characterization of material. So this may be interesting for people from ECOI and other people doing modeling, that within Ampea there is a lot of experts of material, experts that can help to provide some facilities, so access to facilities, large scale facilities. Here we have the case of neutron scattering on a big line of neutron reactor in Saclay to characterize material, and this is. To my mind, I think important to be able to make links between experiments and simulation. So here, this was the case for an example on a fuel cell module for characterization in operando of these membranes. As I will discuss about a bit about this later. The action act, the artificial photosynthesis, which is the most advanced within Ampère, has developed also during the past year a lot of things on material for catalysis, for splitting water to produce hydrogen. And in that frame, this is a typical example of, I will say, multi-scale modeling that can be useful for us to promote and to develop this action. So this was supported by several experts within Europe in that field, and they have published on a kind of roadmap on artificial photosynthesis in review paper and books. So I will come to modeling, and what is at the core of the sub-program tool multiscale modeling within Ampère is to address calculation that can go from the small scale, from the atomic scale, toward the system scale. And all this application, all these calculations should be related to material devoted, or material or processes devoted to energy. So we try to make link between the partners of Ampère and to bring solution to modeling issue that might interest physicians in the or chemistry people in the field of energy application. So I will show you some example of things that have been carried out during the past year. So this first example was about modeling and elaboration of new thermoelectric materials. This was an answer to a call for Marie Curie action. And in that case, we were interested in the modeling of new thermoelectric materials. And to design and to propose new materials, you have to make calculation, and especially calculation at small scale. Make DFT calculation of the material to evaluate their thermal and their electronic properties, but also calculation at larger scale by means of molecular dynamics to see the correct nanostructure that can be efficient for your energy conversion. And you can even go to mesoscale with try to reproduce what is done in lab when people do some material like this using multiscale approach for elaborating the material from the atomic to the mesoscale. So in that frame, we have a project that have been proposed gathering 12 people, 12 groups from Ampère. We have another example which is here related to photoartificial photosynthesis. In that frame, people are also interested in modeling for different reasons. The first one is that when you want to make the production of hydrogen from water, in that case, you have to design the best possible material that can do the catalysis of water and to split molecules. So there is a need of ab initio and small scale modeling of the material to determine the best properties. But you have also to deal with large scale devices and try to make it working in a, I will say, industrial way. So you have to develop also models and tools to go from very accurate calculation at the scale of the material itself toward the scale of the system. So this was quite important for us to improve numerical tools and model to go from the material to the system scale. There is another project which was proposed to NMBP. So in that project, people are also interested in the management of hydrogen. And this is the case of membrane. This is membrane used for the separation of hydrogen from gas mixture. And in that project, which is a high-tech membrane, we want to replace palladium, which is a costly, very costly compounds from membranes, and try to find which could be the most suitable material that can achieve the separation of hydrogen for a lower cost than it is done presently. So to do that, people works on two parallel ways. The first one is to design new material, doing a computational material screening of a given number of material properties, like hydrogen adsorption in material and so on, and try to make a list of the best possible candidate of material to replace palladium, and try to elaborate them. So this project was has passed the first rank of the evaluation, and was desperately not the second one, but was well ranked, and we hope that we can resubmit it and make it good this time. Similarly, in the case of hydrogen, there is people in London at UCL that works on the storage of hydrogen, so they study also by means of atomic calculation the storage of hydrogen and the release of hydrogen within materials. So once again, they need tools for carrying out material screening. This is a bit the same as previously. So this is for very small scale. There is also people working at larger scale. Here I will show you some example of what is done in DLR in Germany. They are interested in CMC. CMC are ceramic fiber which are embedded in ceramic matrix. So this is light element, this is light material, but they can be subjected to very high temperature evolution. You can see here, this is a part of a gas turbine. And for such material, there is risk of degradation and risk of failure. So they use, I would say, quite well-known tools for evaluation of temperature profile and material elastic modulus. But after that, they develop their in-house code to compute the risk of failure of this material. So in that field, they also need support to develop codes. And I will finish with the presentation of which be one of the most advanced modeling environment within Ampere, which is actually led by VTT in Finland. It is on the design of material for different kind of application. I will show you. And they go from the microstructure, so we are a bit more larger than the atomic scale, and try to make simulation of the process of degradation and of this material, which might be subjected to stresses or thermal cycling, and try to make connection between what they make in terms of simulation and also what they can do in terms of characterization. So applications are quite broad. They work on thin film coatings, they work on composite materials, metals and polymers. And the approach is also typically multi-scale. They go from the alloy, considering grain and property at small scale, making thermodynamic calculation to optimize the calculation of properties of material, and going toward the application with the possible, I would say, deformation or stresses applied to devices, toward the final product. So they send me the slide, and you can see all the library and all the tools that can be involved in such an approach, going from small scales toward the system scale. So this environment is quite well developed, but I think that they are also interested in improving the tools they are developing. And I will finish saying that I think that there is a lot of things to be done in common with ECHO, as we have thematics that are quite close, especially in the field of materials. There is a lot of outcomes that can, I have taken it from your website, that can be useful for us in terms of high performance computing. We have a lot of people who are doing calculation at small scale, ab initio and molecular dynamic calculation, and they need to access to computation grids and facilities that can make their calculation possible. There is people who are developing in-house code, and I think that they will be happy to improve their code and the way this is physician that make numerical tools. It is not expert, I will say, in terms of programming. And I can say that Ampère can also provide access to a large scale material community. There is a lot of experimentalists and people that make material within Ampère, and this could be interesting for you also to have access to this characterization facilities to compare with simulation and tools that are developed within ECHO environment. And I think that we can push also together joint project on at national or European level, as we do within Ampère, associating people from experimentation and people from modeling part. So this is not closed, and discussion could be open. So I will finish thanking people that helped me to prepare this slide. Frédéric Chandozon, who should be here today to present you Ampère, as he is the leader of this joint program. Thank you for attention.